Hello, hello, my friends. Welcome back to my caliente kitchen. It's beautiful day here in San Francisco. I love a good sunny day in San Francisco. I hope it's sunny where you are, not too hot. Well, as many of you know, unfortunately, last month I was in the hospital due to a skin infection and for a long time, and I'll get into details in a second, but because of that, I was given lots of antibiotics, and that affected my gastrointestinal tract, my microbiome, which can lead to more infections and inflammation. So today we're gonna share how to restore your gut health naturally, okay? Very important, and what to do if you end up in a hospital with antibiotics, what to do. All right, so as I was telling you, this skin infection was a staph infection, and just so you know, there's tons of bacteria living in our bodies, and the one that unfortunately got into my system was the worst of the staph, and it was called MRSA. So MRSA is resistant to antibiotics, and I was hospitalized for 12 days, and I was given intravenous IV three types of antibiotics. It was crazy. And after my hospitalization, I was in home with another potent oral antibiotic. So there was a war going on in my gastrointestinal system and affected my GI tract, my microbiome. So, what is microbiome? Microbiome is your kingdom, is the place where bacteria lives, from the gastrointestinal system and the colon and your small intestine colon. And we have over trillion of bacteria cells living there. There are more bacteria living in your GI tract than people in the world. Amazing fact. Unfortunately, when you get treated with antibiotics don't not only go and kill the bad bacteria, but also kill the good bacteria, which is probiotics. And we know now, through research, of course, that good bacteria helps your immune system. So it's kind of like a vicious cycle. Here we have, you know, treating an infection, but at the same time, lowering your good bacteria. So your balance of good versus bad, not so good. Now, not having a good balance has been linked to inflammation, infections, even can affect your mood and mental health. There's tons of research on these. So here I am being treated by an infection, this MRSA. And by the way, anyone can get MRSA. It doesn't matter how healthy you are. I'm telling you, I've never have seen a doctor, let alone end up in ER and hospitalized for 12 days. Crazy. Yes, crazy. So, like the doctor says, Manuel, you won the lotto. Well, this is not the kind of lotto I want to win. But anyways, so how to restore your gastrointestinal system? How to restore, how to bring back those good bacteria, those probiotics in your system? Well, while you in the hospital, while I was in the hospital, I can tell you about my experience, and thank God I'm a registered dietitian, so I knew to take action immediately. This is why I wanna share this with you. I looked at the menu in the hospital and I dissected this menu, and I needed to make sure that I get my probiotics through food. And I found Greek yogurt, plain Greek yogurt. And I was like, yes. So I was asking for Greek yogurt morning, day, and night for every single meal. Even I was eating as a snack. And then of course, they were giving me a supplement as well, which is much necessary then. And I was taking a probiotic supplement and eating my probiotics. And of course, also, I was looking for the side dishes in the menu for vegetables, and especially fiber, because fiber helps. And we're gonna discuss that in a second when I make this beautiful two meals that are gut friendly. At the end, you know this is a cooking show, so I'm gonna have to give you recipes, but these are two delicious recipes. All right, so are you ready? Let's get cooking, my friends. So the first recipe, it has probiotics and prebiotics. So probiotics are the good bacteria, and they come from fermented foods. Fermented dairy, for example, fermented dairy like kefir, cottage cheese. Yes, I bought cottage cheese that has probiotics. I'll discuss it in a second. And fermented vegetables like sauerkraut. And I'm gonna show you what to do when you buy these foods as well. So what I'm making here now is a probiotic prebiotic. Now, prebiotics is the fiber that probiotics like to eat. What good does it to continue taking probiotics, but you're not feeding the prebiotic? You're not feeding the probiotic with prebiotics. Prebiotics are fermentable fibers. So, not only is it important to eat probiotics, but it's extremely important to add prebiotic fibers in your diet as well. You have to do both, because probiotics will multiply, and we want more probiotics. So if you don't feed them, they're not gonna multiply, they're not gonna grow, they're not gonna make you strong, because your immune system will get weakened. We need to have a healthy gut. So every day, I eat something with probiotics. And it doesn't have to be a lot, something. And I, to be honest with you, I've always been doing that, to have a good, healthy gut. So this salad, let's start now. It has beans. Beans are considered a prebiotic, by the way. I'm gonna get my spoon here, so I start mixing. I added some carrots for fiber. So by the way, it's not just fermented fiber that is important. We need to also add just fiber, soluble fiber, insoluble fiber, and fermentable fiber. Fiber is good for your gut as well, every fiber. All right, then I'm gonna add some corn, more fiber, and of course, look at the colors, full of antioxidants and phytonutrients because it's anti-inflammatory as well. Then I'm gonna get some radishes in here. Of course, I love radishes, colorful stuff. And avocados, which they contain soluble fiber and of course good fat as well. And by the way, the good fat in avocado can help you absorb some of these phytonutrients that are fat soluble. So then I'm gonna add some jicama. Now jicama is a vegetable from Mexico, origins from Mexico, maybe Central America I should say, and is known to be a potent prebiotic. So add jicama to your diet, and I found my jicama at Safeway. I didn't have to go to my Latino store for jicama. You can find jicama almost anywhere now. Then, of course, sauerkraut. Now, not all fermented foods contain probiotics. Be careful with this now. So the foods that I buy, especially the sauerkraut, is refrigerated, number one, and it has to be refrigerated because it has living organisms, it has those probiotics. And I read in the package, they have to tell you that the strains that they have, and it has probiotics, because you can buy sauerkraut, canned sauerkraut in the middle of the aisles. That sauerkraut doesn't have probiotics. It is fermented, but it doesn't have probiotics. So you need to make sure you buy food that tells you in the package it has probiotics. It's extremely important. Mix this really well. Smells so delicious. And then of course we're gonna add red onions. Onions also are prebiotics, by the way. So as you see, this one has prebiotics and probiotics. This salad is delicious and is feeding your gut. It's feeding the good bacteria and my lovely cilantro. As a good Latino, I'm gonna add that there too. Oh, it smells so good. Oh, I can eat the whole thing. And we're gonna season this with olive oil. There you go. And rice vinegar. Love rice vinegar for some good flavor. Of course, some sea salt and black pepper. And then we're gonna stir this well. All right. So, and you know, when you make this salad, since with the vinegar and the oil, let it sit for about 10 minutes, things will start tasting really good. And of course, the sauerkraut already has a little bit of the deliciousness flavor. This salad is so good. And this salad, you can accompany salmon, grilled chicken, steak, you name it, any meat you like, or maybe no meat. If you don't eat meat, do some eggs and pair with some cheeses too. It's really good. I love this salad with almost anything. All right, the next recipe I'm going to make is a smoothie. Now this smoothie here, I'm gonna put this here for now, and then I'm gonna do tasting after. This smoothie can be a good breakfast smoothie, and it has probiotics. So we're gonna start with kefir. Kefir is fermented yogurt liquid form. They have different brands now in the market, refrigerated, good source of prebiotics, and most kefirs will tell you the different strains of probiotics that they contain. And then of course, I'm gonna sweeten this with some mango. Mango, good fiber as well. And I like to buy frozen mango, so it's easy. And then cottage cheese. Yes, I learned cottage cheese also, it has probiotics. But again, not all cottage cheeses have probiotics. You have to buy the one with probiotics. You just read on the label, it will tell you that it has probiotics. And I love to add cottage cheese because it makes it so creamy and actually it's a good source of protein, quality, high quality protein. All right, and then cinnamon, just for some good flavor, and sweeten this with honey. Now, and it's so good. Ooh. Now this is raw honey that I'm using here. There we go. All right, because the kefir, by the way, it has, it's sour. The cottage cheese is not so sour, but it's really good. It's a little bit of a salt. So now you're combining salt. The kefir that I bought is not non-fat, it's low-fat kefir. Now you have a little bit of fat, sort of with the cottage cheese. So when you combine salt, sugar, and fat, yummy. You have the perfect combination. All right, so we'll make this smoothie quickly, and then we're gonna have a beautiful taste here. All right, so let's pour some here. So good. Look at that creaminess, so delicious. All right, so now I'm gonna serve myself some of this beautiful salad in here. Just to taste right now. And we're gonna have my beautiful, I'm gonna move this here so you can see me better. We're gonna have some of this beautiful prebiotic, probiotic veggie salad. All right, with jicama. I'm gonna get the jicama and everything. The flavors are so good together. Very summer, very fresh, very gut healthy, and wow, delicious, of course. And now I'm gonna have a little bit of my gut-friendly smoothie. Got a little gut milk mark in there. Okay, a winner, definitely. So you can have this for breakfast, this for lunch with your beautiful fish or chicken or steak or whatever you like. And I'm telling you, you can have nutritious, healthy food that can actually help your gastrointestinal system, especially if you're going through some treatment with antibiotics. And that's how I restore my gut, I swear. And I have healed fast because my gastrointestinal system was being taken care of. So remember, I am across social media. If you want to learn about my services, visit manuelvillacorta.com. Also, I have a blog at manuelvillacorta.com where you can find more recipes. And if you want me to become your weight loss coach, check me out, manuelvillacorta.com or envynutrition.com. I hope you have